Hello dear students, with this lecture we will be starting our next invertebrate phylum, which is phylum Eschehelminthes, and it is also referred as phylum Nemetehelminthes. The organisms belonging to this phylum are generally referred as bagworms, roundworms or threadworms due to their morphology. There are about 50 species of roundworms which are found as human parasites. Let us now take a look at their general features. So first of all, about their habitat. Eschehelminths, they occur almost in every kind of habitat, but most of them they live as parasites in animals and plants. The next is about their body form. Here is a photograph of Ascaris, which belongs to this phylum. Here we can see that these organisms, they have cylindrical, unsegmented, thread-like body and they do not have any lateral appendages. Then their next features include, like the organisms of the phylum Platyhelminthes, Eschehelminths, they are also triploblastic animals. They have organ system level of organization and they have bilateral symmetry. About these three features, we have already studied in little detail in one of our previous lecture, which was about the general features of the phylum Platyhelminthes. Then next is about their body wall. Their body wall of these organisms, it consists of three layers, out of which the outermost layer is non-living or acellular cuticle, and below cuticle is present the epidermis, which is syncytial. Syncytial का मतलब होता है कि बहुत सारे cells एक दूसरे के साथ fuse कर जाएंगे और उन सारे cells का cytoplasm जो है वो continuous हो जाएगा, and a very large mass of cytoplasm is formed in which many nuclei they are present. So such layer is termed as the syncytial layer or the syncytial epidermis. Below the epidermis is present the muscle layer, which consists only of the longitudinal muscle fibers, means the circulatory or the circular muscles, they are altogether absent in the body wall. Then next is about their body cavity. In Eschehelminthes, there is a cavity present between the body wall and the alimentary canal, and this body cavity is not the true coelom, rather it is referred as false coelom or the pseudo coelom. So what is the difference between the false coelom and the true coelom? Let us understand this with help of this simplified diagram. This diagram, it represents the transverse sections of different animals. So this first is the simplified transverse section of the of a acoelomate. For example, any of the Platyhelminthes, these organisms, they do not have any body cavity or coelom at all. Then this second diagram is transverse section of a eucoelomate. These are those organisms which have true coelom. For example, the organisms belonging to the phylum Annelida and most of the higher organisms. These organisms, as we can see here, they have depicted here in brown color. They have a body cavity or coelom, and their body cavity on all the sides is surrounded or lined by the mesodermal layer. Precisely, the mesodermal layer or the mesodermal epithelium which lines the coelom is termed as peritoneum. So if the peritoneum, it lines the coelom on all the sides, such coelom is termed as true coelom. But in case of the organisms of the phylum Eschehelminthes, as we can see in this third diagram, this coelom or this body cavity is present, but on the outer side it is lined by the mesoderm, but on the inner side it is lined by the endoderm, means peritoneum, it do not line the coelom on all the sides. So such coelom is referred as false coelom or the pseudo coelom. This pseudocoelom of Eschehelminthes, it is filled with a fluid which is referred as pseudocoelomic fluid, which act as hydraulic skeleton, means it helps in maintaining the shape of the body, and it also act as the circulatory fluid which helps in circulation or in transfer of the material from one part of the body to the other part. Then next is their digestive tract. In these organisms, the alimentary canal or the digestive tract is complete, means it have both mouth as well as anus. But the important is that the wall of the alimentary canal, it do not have any muscles, or the alimentary canal's wall is non-muscular. These organisms, they do not have any specific respiratory system, and respiration, it occurs by diffusion of the gases through general body surface. The next is about their excretory system. In most of the SK helminthes, the whole excretory system, it consists of a single very large H-shaped cell, which is referred as Rennet cell. This is a magnified diagram of the Rennet cell. Here we can see that this Rennet cell, it consists of two longitudinal excretory canals which are interconnected to each other by these transverse canals. Here is the nucleus of this very large cell, and at the anterior most tip of this Rennet cell is present a small excretory pore. So this is magnified diagram of Rennet cell, but on the left side in this diagram we can see how this large cell is positioned within the body of the worm. Here we can see that these two anterior limbs of this H-shaped cell, they are much smaller in comparison to the posterior, these two posterior limbs of this cell. So the whole excretory system in most of the SK helminth, it consists of this single cell. So such system can be termed as intracellular excretory system. But in some of the organisms of this phylum SK helminth, instead of Rennet cell, protonephridia, they are present. They help in excretion or osmoregulation. Then next comes their nervous system. These organisms, they have quite well developed nervous system, which consists of nerve ring and the nerves. Then another very important feature of SK helminthes is that in these organisms, the number of cells is usually fixed in every organ or every part of the body, and this phenomenon is termed as eutelly. In these organisms, mitosis, it stops after the embryonic development, means the cells, they do not divide in adult organisms, and the growth, it only occurs by the enlargement of the cells, which is termed as the oxyntic growth. For example, if there are two roundworms, for example, one of them is larger and another is comparatively smaller. और अगर हम इन दोनों वॉर्म्स के किसी पर्टिकुलर बॉडी पार्ट को अगर मॉर्फोलॉजिकली कंपेयर करें, फॉर एग्जांपल अगर हम उनके एलिमेंट्री कैनाल को कंपेयर करें, तो ऑब्वियसली जो लार्जर वॉर्म होगा उसका एलिमेंट्री कैनाल वुड बी लार्जर, एंड द स्मॉलर वॉर्म जो होगा उसका एलिमेंट्री कैनाल वुड बी कंपैरेटिवली स्मॉलर. बट इफ वी काउंट द नंबर ऑफ सेल्स इन द एलिमेंट्री कैनाल ऑफ बोथ दीज ऑर्गेनिजम्स, द नंबर ऑफ सेल्स वुड बी सेम. डिफरेंस सिर्फ क्या चीज़ होगा कि जो लार्जर वॉर्म होगा उसका एलिमेंट्री कैनाल का जो इंडिविजुअल सेल होगा उसका साइज वुड बी लार्जर, और जो स्मॉलर वॉर्म होगा उसकी एलिमेंट्री कैनाल में उसका इंडिविजुअल सेल का साइज वुड बी स्मॉलर. सो दिस फिनोमिनन इज टर्म्ड एज यूटेली, वेयर द नंबर ऑफ सेल्स इज फिक्स्ड इन एवरी ऑर्गन. दिस इज वेरी स्पेसिफिक फीचर ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऑफ दिस फाइलम. देन नेक्स्ट कम्स अबाउट देयर सेंस ऑर्गन्स. दीज ऑर्गेनिजम्स, दे हैव प्रिमिटिव टाइप ऑफ सेंस ऑर्गन्स विच इंक्लूड पैपिले, एम्फिड्स एंड फास्मिड्स, विच आर मोस्टली सेंसिटिव फॉर केमिकल्स. देन नेक्स्ट इज अबाउट देयर रिप्रोडक्शन. मोस्ट ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऑफ फाइलम एस के हेलमिंथिस, दे आर यूनिसेक्सुअल और डायोशियस, मीन्स सेक्सेस दे आर सेपरेट. देर इज मेल एंड फीमेल इंडिविजुअल्स, दे आर सेपरेट, दे आर डिफरेंट, एंड दे ऑलवेज शो सेक्सुअल डायमॉर्फिज्म. सेक्सुअल डायमॉर्फिज्म का मतलब है कि मेल एंड फीमेल ऑर्गेनिजम्स, दे कैन बी डिस्टिंग्विश्ड एक्सटर्नली और मॉर्फोलॉजिकली, एज वी कैन सी अगेन इन दिस फोटोग्राफ विच इज ऑफ एस्कैरिस. वन इज द फीमेल एस्कैरिस एंड अदर इज मेल एस्कैरिस. वी कैन डिस्टिंग्विश देम एक्सटर्नली. As we can see here, the female ascaris is comparatively longer, and the female ascaris has its hind end is straight, while in case of male ascaris, its hind end is comparatively curved. So these are the few of the differences between the male and the female organism. So this phenomenon where we can distinguish the male and female externally, this is referred as sexual dimorphism. And in case of SK helminthes, none of the SK helminthes, they show asexual mode of reproduction. Next comes the unique features of these organisms. These are the features which are specific for these organisms. About all of these features we have just studied. We'll just recapitulate them once again. These organisms, they have syncytial epidermis. Their body wall, it contain only the longitudinal muscle fiber. They have this pseudocoelom. Their next feature is the Eutele, which is fixed number of cells in most of the body parts. Then next is their non-muscular elementary canal, and last is the Rennet cell, which forms its excretory system. So these are the unique features of the organisms of phylum Aeschylomyces. And then next comes the features which prove that organisms of phylum Aeschylomyces, they are comparatively advanced or comparatively superior to the Platyhelminthes, which include their complete elementary canal or complete digestive tract. As we know, in the Platyhelminths, they in many of them the elementary canal is altogether absent, and if it is present, it only have mouth, means the elementary canal is incomplete. Then next is the presence of the body cavity or the coelom in case of Aeschylomyces, while in case of Platyhelminthes, the coelom is altogether absent. Then next is Aeschylomyces, they are unisexual organisms, means sexes they are separate, while Platyhelminthes, most of them, they are hermaphrodite organism. And last advancement is that Aeschylomyces, they lack asexual reproduction altogether, while there are few Platyhelminthes which show this asexual mode of reproduction, which is considered comparatively primitive mode of reproduction. Then finally comes the classification of the phylum Aeschylomyces. Many taxonomists, they consider Aeschylomyces as a superphylum, but will follow the classification which was given by Hyman. And Hyman, he considered Aeschylomyces as a phylum only. Hyman, he divided Aeschylomyces in 7 classes, out of which 5 are comparatively important. So, we will study only these 5 classes. These are the 5 classes of the phylum Aeschylomyces, and we will study their characters in a comparative form. So, first of all, this organisms of class Nematoda, which is the first class, these organisms, they can be free living, but most of them, they are parasites, for example Ascaris, Fusaria, Oxyuris. Then the second class is Nematomorpha. These organisms are generally aquatic, but they can be also found in the damp soil, and the examples include the Paragordius. Then the next class is the class Rotifera. These organisms are mostly present in fresh water, and the example include Escomorpha. Then next is the Gastrotrichum. These organisms are mostly aquatic, and their example include Cephalodiaceae. The last class is class Caenorhynchia, and these organisms are exclusively marine, and their example include Echinodirella. Then their next feature is the body wall. In case of the organisms of class Nematoda, their body wall, the cuticle present in the body wall is very thin, but the cuticle of the organisms of the class Nematomorpha, it is comparatively thicker, and it have the collagen fibers. In case of the organisms of class Rotifera, their cuticle is formed by numerous small plates, and individual plate is termed as lorica. In the organisms of class Gastrotrichia, their cuticle it is formed into very small spines, and the cuticle, it also contain numerous cilia. In organisms of class Caenorhynchia, the cuticle has spines, but it do not have any cilia. So the difference between the cuticle of these organisms, it form the primary basis of the classification. The next feature is about their elementary canal. The elementary canal is complete in the organisms of Nematoda, Rotifera, Gastrotrichia, as well as Caenorhynchia, but in the organisms of the class Nematomorpha, the elementary canal is vestigial or non-functional in their adults, as the adults, they live for a very short period, and during this period they do not feed at all. Then the last feature is about their difference is about their excretory system. The excretory system is formed of the rennet cell in the nematodes, and the excretory system is altogether absent in the organisms of class Nematomorpha and Kynorhynchia. And the excretory system is formed by the protonephridia in the class Rotifera and Gastrotrycha. So this is all about the classification of the this phylum Aeschylomyces, and that is all for today. Thank you so much.